What a beautiful day to begin with. Thank you so much for being with us. And today I am going to review a Lijo Juse Pellicery, how they say it in Spanish, Lijo Juse Pellicery, his movie Ima Yo, Yeshu, Mariam, and Yusuf. Before moving further with the synopsis or what the story is, today let me talk about my own personal experience, and I can relate very well how the story will fascinate you also, especially tell you how the people behave, and even at the end or the final journey of the person, their true color will always shine at the wrong time. So the story is all about, as the title says, is Yeshu, Mariam, Joseph, Yusuf, a son, mother, and father. So the story is also about this relationship, and it will I will discuss. So let me discuss something more personal. It could be very easy for me to relate it, because that's how people will learn or earn from your experience. Like almost like 14 years ago, we lost our aunt, and on Sunday she was very fine, and on the Monday she died very sudden. People who met her on Sunday, they didn't believe that she is gone. Morning, no one came. Afternoon, no one came. People keep on calling that this happened. Around 4 p.m. or 3 p.m., all people gathered and they kept saying, it is reality. That's how it happens most of the time, when they keep seeing a person who is very fine, and very next moment, it happened in the movie also, you can also see it. And then there comes another also, very closer also, like something like, so like it was about to be, the funeral was about to happen, and we say that the money is a little bit short, we need to contribute, would you really like to contribute? No, I don't want to contribute. The condition is this, that the body should come at my doorstep. The parents comes first, so we have to just consider. No, we don't need to consider. The situation is that I am the one, and I wanted to show my supremacy, that okay, it comes at my door. It also happened in the movie also. That's why, because I don't know, I'm not naming, because it's for my family members, that's why. So overall it is similar situation, and you will understand sometimes that happens. And then I have to run around here and there, borrow, and then get things done. It was very challenging phase of life. Yeah, you can understand. The story starts with a coastal village of Chalanam around Kochi. And at the beginning of the movie, you could see there is a funeral going on, and you can see how the people are marching. It shows that something magnificent or final farewell is given ritually with a good way. That happened at the beginning. And then you see Babachan is traveling and coming with a duck. And on his way, he saw people of his community, because it's in a village area. They were playing cards and they were discussing something. People were gossiping about, oh, here he comes. So Choro is a guy who was picking a fight on Babachan. Look, your daughter has a premarital relationship, Nisa, and with the another guy, what is that? With Shivanapu, I don't know how to name, sorry. And at the beginning of the movie, you could also see it, that there is a guy sitting with a girl. So they wanted to give you a hint that what is about to happen. The problem is that sometimes we didn't focus on the details, and this is a beauty in the Japanese cinema and the South End cinema, that they have brought this very unique thing. And if you really can't get the good content, if you can deliver your message in details, it is very best. You don't need dialogues also, and that happens in this one also. It's very good. You will really like this, how the things are telling you, but you will relate all these things. So now Babachan comes back, and very friendly, talking to his wife, and his wife is saying, why you are just running around here and there to settle? Whatever is done, And now there is his son Ishii, who is there, and he sees his father being friendly, talk to him that, "Oh father, don't think about all these things and just be like this. And when you will die, I will give you a very glorious final farewell, much better than all other people in Charanam that have." As the food was prepared, suddenly there is a cry that they heard that his father died. So now Ishii is upset. Very suddenly, very quickly, whatever he promised is about to get started. And thus his friend, a panchayat leader, comes. His name is Ayappan. So all these two characters, I watched them in another movie. I will just review it later why I watched their movie. They are here. So now that's a good thing you will learn from Ayappan, that a good friends and good neighbors are all those who are taking a charge of this kind of situation when you really need them in a desperate situations. Being a leader, community member, he stepped forward and tried his level best to arrange everything. I saw many people also, they have been doing the same similar thing till date, even though whatever the urban setup has changed or not, they know that sometimes these deeds are done for the benefit, or not saying benefit, it's like your reward is up above in the sky, not on the ground. And they do that. So Ayappan was trying to gather all these things, coffin, cross, and all these things, whatever. And then talking to Ishii that, "Okay, whatever you really wanted to pick up, so that we can at least listen whatever you have committed with your father." All these things are being planned and everything is on its way. And then they are talking to Father Zakaria, the vicar, about the final farewell and the other processions and all for his burial, the place in the church cemetery and everything. Ayappan is trying his level best to talk to each and every place and everything. He's doing it. Suddenly, from nowhere, his second wife shows up, and then with his son. This is the real son of a mystery. There is no other son. This son has already killed his own father. So thus they created a chaos there. So is it a murder or is it a natural death? But he has a sign on his head. Thus they are saying that how we should solve this. And Ayappan is saying that no need to create a scene here also. Thus father comes also, father saw all this, and then they say, father said, "Oh no, I have seen there is a sign of wound and I will not give permission. Let's ask the police, it is a police case." Thus the furious son Ishii gets angry at all those people. "Why you are just making a scene, and suddenly from nowhere this lady shows up and saying, claiming the body?" So father has already played his superior role, like, "No, I am the in charge now, I will not say yes to it." Honestly, he did a good job, but at that time, sometimes it happens that the community should come together, join their heads together to come up a good amicable settlement, that they should not be beyond what is happening right now. So all the drama and everything, and then he slapped father. No, Father Zakaria just called all the police and everything that this has happened and I think it is a murder, you should investigate. Ayappan gets upset that why suddenly all these things are happening. So Ayappan trying his level best to solve this and let the deceased give its final farewell, and it was raining. He went to the police station, talked to them that this is like this. Police came also, they saw that there is a sign of wound, and then they say, and then they brought a doctor. And the doctor say, "He is already sick. I know. I am his family doctor. And this sign of what is that wound is a very minor one. He fell down. Definitely, it is from there. It is not a deep one. And if somebody could have done it, it should be deep, so that the person could die. It is not deep." Things were solved, but still everyone wanted to play their part. Step back, watching what the drama is going on. Father not stepping in to solve, and he is now in an ego fight that he will talk to the super authorities so that things will get more worse here. that annoys his son, who wanted to give a final farewell. Thus starts the scene. And you will really enjoy it, what happens in the end. Thank you so much for bearing me. I hope you will really enjoy it. It is best to watch it. You could relate and understand why building a good community is important. Why we really need to stick to each other through thick and thin, to give ourselves like a feeling that definitely there is someone at the wrong time, like Ayappan, who can come and be helpful, someone to lean upon, someone to play a vital role at the crucial and mandatory situations of our human life. Sorry for a long time. Thank you so much. Have a great week. And love your loved ones and all those who even don't love you. Take care and stay blessed. Bye-bye.